Packaging and transportation. Packaging and transportation also contribute to the carbon footprint in a device's life cycle. The two main contributors in this segment are the materials used for packaging and the carbon footprint of the vehicles used in transportation. Since the materials used in packaging a device have an effect on the device's carbon footprint, the amount of material used for packaging needs to be kept at a minimum. The packaging should be done in such a way that it minimizes the amount of material used whilst ensuring the integrity and security of the device. The size of the device has an effect on the amount of packaging required, so even during the design stage, effort must be made to make the device as compact as possible. Eco-friendly materials like recycled paper, potato starch and recycled board can be used as packaging materials, and soy ink can be used for printing. The following are general recommendations for designing suitable packaging, U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, 2011. 1. Packaging materials should be recyclable. 2. The amount of packaging materials should be kept at a minimum. 3. Various materials used in packaging should be easily separable to ease the recycling process. 4. Adhesive use should be reduced by using folds and tabs instead. 5. All the additives, coatings and inks that get added to the package should be eco-friendly. 6. Printed documentation can be avoided wherever possible. Instead, documentation could be provided through the device's web page. In addition, freight transportation leads to a lot of carbon emission. Along with making the transport system efficient, the design of the device should facilitate smarter transportation. For example, the smaller the device, the more of them can be transported in a given space, thus reducing the number of vehicles required to transport them from manufacturing facilities to distribution centers.